A very good morning to everybody. Greetings to all from the Department of Mathematics, Women's Christian College, Nagarkoil. Respected correspondent, beloved principal, honorable chief guest, dear colleagues from the Department of Mathematics, dear participants, we heartily welcome you all for the webinar on Even Gracefulness of Some Families of Graphs. Now, I invite Dr. T. Muthun Esabula, Assistant Professor of Mathematics, to welcome you all.
Respected President of this function, Honorable Correspondent cum Secretary of our esteemed institution, faculty members and all other participants, good morning to all. First of all, I welcome our Principal, Dr. C.M. Batma. I welcome you, ma'am. Next, I would like to extend my warm welcome to our Correspondent, Dr. Asir Pakesing. Next, I welcome our guest of honor and resource person, Dr. A. Chandrababu, former Vice Principal and Head Department of Mathematics, American College, Autonomous, Madurai. On behalf of all the faculty members, I welcome you, sir. I feel honored to welcome all the faculty members and all other participants for taking a keen part in this important program. I am sure that you all will feel enriched with knowledge after completion of this extent. I welcome you all once again to all the webinar and hope that you will have a great time ahead. Thank you.
Let us now welcome the personality who is known among all of us for her wisdom and her knowledge, our Honorable Principal Dr. C.M. Batma. Now I request our Principal to give away the presidential address.
Respected Head of the Department of Mathematics, Dr. Leena, Honorable Resource Person, Dr. A. Chandrababu, former Head of the Department of Mathematics and Vice Principal, American College, Madurai, faculties and my dear participants. A very warm good morning to you all. I thank the Lord Almighty for the opportunity He has given to me to link with you through this webinar on even gracefulness of some families of graphs. I congratulate the department for their efforts to have this webinar today, especially my best wishes to Dr. Leena, the new head of the Department of Mathematics of our college. I'm happy about this department, for it was raised as a research center recently by the Manonmaniam Sundaranar University, Tirunelveli. And the very first webinar arranged by them is a witness of higher learning. Thanks to the coordinators, Dr. Muthun Esabula and Dr. Vijay Kumar Sarada, for their efforts in having this program today. And I'm extremely happy as well as grateful to the resource person, for he is willing to spare his valuable time with us this morning through this webinar. Basically, I'm a physicist, but I love mathematics than physics. I used to tell to my students often that I like physics, but I love mathematics. But of course, to me, now both are important. Mathematics, skeletal work, plus physics, flesh part. Totally, human being is a fullness of these two. When we add the two, mathematics plus physics, mathematical physics. Dr. William Paul Thurston said, mathematics is not about numbers, equations, computations, or algorithms. It's all about understanding. Mathematics is the music of reason. Numbers are very, very important in mathematics as well as in life too. whether it is odd or even, both are special. The pictorial representation is given in any subject by graphs. Journey of life is also a graphical representation. Childhood and oldhood, they are exchangeable in characters, but youth is the peak of any graph. It is the most important part of anyone's life. To me, in your topic, first and the last are important, and many things I can tell about that too. But the mid part is the most important, just like what I mentioned earlier about graphs. And I hope it all be explained by the resource person with us this morning. Mathematics may not teach us to add love or subtract hate, but it gives us hope that every problem has a solution. Every problem has a solution that is clearly revealed by mathematics. It's a great thing about mathematics too. But in our journey, life can also be a mathematical equation with numbers, symbols, letters, etc. In order to gain the most, you have to know how to convert negatives into positives. And in all our efforts, we are longing to reap success. That's my wish too. Success, it also uses mathematics. Success is the sum of efforts, sum of small efforts. When I mean sum, it doesn't mean S-O-M-E, but it is S-U-M. It is also still in mathematics. So my wish this morning to all of you is have a successful day and have a successful webinar. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for your nice words. We are excited to hear some words of our today's chief guest, Dr. A. Chandrababu, former head of the Department of Mathematics, American College, Madurai. He had 37 years of experience in American College. After his retirement, he served in Nurul Islam College. He has guided 4 scholars. He has published more than 20 papers in various national and international journals. It's a great honor to have with you, sir. Now, I invite our chief guest to give his precious inputs.
To begin with, let me thank all of you. I thank the principal of Women's Christian College, Nagarkoil, the head of the Department of Mathematics, and the other faculty members for organizing this webinar. I thank all of them for inviting me and giving me this opportunity to talk to you. I welcome all of you. Have a nice day. The topic for my lecture, as already announced, is even graceful graph. even gracefulness of some families of graphs. The origin of graph theory can be traced to the work of the Swiss mathematician Leonhard Euler. He lived between 1707 and 1783. There was a famous unsolved problem during his period, that was the Königsberg bridge problem. Euler solved this problem in the year 1736. That was the origin of a collection of graphs called Eulerian graphs. A graph is said to be Eulerian if there is a closed path in the graph containing all the edges. In this graph, a person starting from one vertex can trace or walk through all the edges and return to the starting point. Similarly, in the year 1856, one William Hamilton invented a game called Game of Dodecahedron. And this is the starting point of a collection of graphs called Hamiltonian graphs. In a Hamiltonian graph, a person can start from a vertex and visit each vertex exactly once and return to the starting point. That is, a Hamiltonian graph contains a spanning cycle, a circuit which contains all the vertices. So this is the second collection of graphs, I would insist. These two collections of graphs, that is Eulerian graphs and Hamiltonian graphs, they are not disjoint. There are several graphs which are Eulerian as well as Hamiltonian. There are many graphs which are Eulerian but not Hamiltonian. At the same time, there are graphs which are Hamiltonian but not Eulerian. Today I am going to give you several other families of graphs, one parameter family, two parameter families, etc. Graph labeling. Graph labeling was first introduced in the mid-60s. A graph labeling is an assignment of integers to the vertices or edges or both, subject to certain conditions. Graph labeling is a prospective research area due to its vital applications. Graceful labeling. Alexandre Rosa has introduced the concept of graceful labeling in the year 1967. A function f is a graceful labeling of a graph G with Q edges if F is an injection from the vertices of G to the set 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. up to Q, such that when each edge UV is assigned the label modulus of FU minus FV, the resulting edge labels are distinct. The graph G with a graceful labeling is called a graceful graph. So each vertex has to be labeled with the label 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. up to Q. Q is the number of edges. The labels of the edges are difference between the labels of the end vertices. Here is an example of a graceful labeling of the prism graph. The prism graph has got 6 edges. So the vertices has to be labeled with numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. up to 6, so that the edges get the induced labels 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, because there are 6 edges. Odd graceful labeling. In 1991, one Dr. Jnana Jyothi has introduced the concept of odd graceful labeling. A graph G with the Q edges is odd graceful if there is an injection F from the vertices of G to the numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. up to Q, 2Q minus 1, such that when each edge UV is assigned the label modulus of FU minus FV, the resulting edge labels are 1, 3, etc., 2q minus 1, all odd numbers. In this case, F is said to be an odd graceful labeling of G. So the vertices has to be labeled with numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, etc., 2q minus 1, so that the induced labels of the edges are 1, 3, etc., up to 2q minus 1, all odd numbers. Here is an example of an odd graceful labeling of the star graph K14. K14 is the complete bipartite graph. It's also called the star graph. Here there are four edges. So the edges have to be labeled with the odd numbers 1, 3, 5, 7. They are derived from the vertex labels, which are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc., 2q minus 1. 2q minus 1 is twice 4 minus 1, so 7. So the edges are labeled with odd numbers 1, 3, 5, 7. Odd gracefulness of some families of graphs. The graph 1K1N, K1M, W is odd graceful, where M and N are positive integers. The graph K1N, K1M, W gives you a collection of two parameter families of graphs. M and N are parameters. For example, K16, K15, W. K16 has, it's a star with vertices, seven vertices. And right side you have K15 with six vertices. And they are connected to a vertex W, here it is labeled 0. And there are 6 plus 1 plus 5 plus 1, so it will be 13 edges available here. And that looks like a tree, that's a tree actually. So there will be 14 vertices. Now they have to be labeled with odd numbers 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, etc. And the right side you will see 13, 15, 17, 19, 21, 23, and 25. 2q minus 1, that is 25. Now there is another graph called the coronagraph, C4K1N. It is odd graceful, where n is any positive integer. This gives you a one parameter family of graphs. Example of the coronagraph C4K16 is given. C4, it's a cycle of length 4. And at each vertex of this cycle, there is a bipartite graph or star graph K16. It's called a coronagraph because on a total solar eclipse, you will see the corona of the sun, and that is the central part, and the lights emanating from the edges. That's why it is called a coronagraph. This graph is odd graceful. Then there is another two parameter family of graphs, the coconut tree, CTMN. It is odd graceful for all positive integers, M and N. In this graph, coconut graph, you have a bipartite graph K113 on the top and a path below, a path of length 6. And again, you can label it as an odd graceful graph. Here is another graph called the Dutch windmill graph, D4 power M. Is odd graceful, where M is any positive integer. Again, one parameter family of graphs. The Dutch windmill graph consists of, here in the example, D4 power 5. There are 5 cycles of length 4 having a common point. And the number of edges are 20. Number of vertices, 21. So the labels for the vertices should be 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. up to 39, 2q minus 1. And you can see that the induced labels are all odd numbers. Then come to even graceful labeling. One Dr. Pasilla has introduced the concept of even graceful labeling in the year 2010. Here the edges have to be labeled with even integers. Definition: an even graceful labeling of a graph G with Q edges is an injection F from the vertices of G to 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. up to 2Q, such that when each edge UV is assigned the label modulus of FU minus FV, the resulting edge labels are even numbers 2, 4, etc. up to 2Q. The graph G with an even graceful labeling is called an even graceful graph. Over here the edges have to be labeled, the induced labels should be 2, 4, etc. up to 2Q, all even numbers. The even graceful labeling of the shadow graph is given here. This shadow graph has a path of length phi at the top, and its reflection is given below. So D2. If this is D3, you will have three steps like this. That has another name actually. Now the image of the top nodes 2, 24, 10, 20, 18 are below. 0, 32, 8, 24, 16. The vertex 28 is adjacent to 2, 0, then 8, 18, I mean 10. So the image of 28, which is 32, has to be adjacent to 2, 0, 8, and 10. It goes like that for other vertices also. This is the shadow graph D2P5, and this graph is even graceful. See, the numbers for the, the labels for the edges are 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, it goes like that. They are the induced, labels induced from the labeling of the vertices with the numbers 0 to 32, 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. up to 2q minus 1. 2q minus 1 is here, 32. Then even gracefulness of some families of graphs. The spider graph S2n has an even graceful labeling for all positive integers n. So we are going to get a one parameter family of even graceful graph. Here is a spider graph S12, 2. That means each leg of the spider has a length 2. It is a path with 3 vertices. There are 12 legs like that, having a common point. It is labeled as 0 here. And such graphs, instead of 12, you can have any number of legs. SN2 is even graceful. Then we will see some graphs. The examples of such graphs have already been seen earlier. The coconut tree CTMN is an even graceful graph where m and n are positive integers. The graph K1n, K1mw is even graceful where m and n are any positive integers. So it gives you a two parameter family of graphs. Then you have got another theorem, let G be a graph such that deletion of every vertex of degree 1 results in a graph, in a path, which is called caterpillar graph. Then there is an even graceful labeling of this graph. I shall give an example. This is a caterpillar graph with having a spine of a path consisting of 4 vertices. This is the path is the spine of this caterpillar graph. The graph has 24 vertices. It's a tree, hence 23 edges. And the graph is even graceful. Now all these theorems have a very long proof. Some theorems run up to 10 to 12 pages. So we will not be able to see the proof of these theorems here. And if you can refer to the proof of these theorems to the papers published by the concerned authors. The coronagraph C4K1N is an even graceful graph where N is any positive integer. Another theorem, the shadow graph D2PN, which we already saw, is an even graceful graph for n greater than or equal to 2. The shadow graph, this is another type of graph, shadow graph D2 K1n. Instead of a path we have got here, K1n is an even graceful graph where n is any positive integer. The example is given D2 K16. So one side one K16, another side the reflection another K16. As I already explained, 28, this vertex 28 is adjacent to 0 and 2. So the image 24 has to be adjacent to 0 and 2. Similarly, other vertices. This is called the shadow graph D2 K16. And this graph can also be labeled as an even graceful graph. This graph P star n plus 2 obtained by adjoining k pendant vertices to any one of the two nodes which are on either side of the nodes of k2n is even graceful, where n is any positive integer. So there are two graphs involved here, one k2n, then there is another path also. In that example we will see n pendant vertices are here. In this graph P6, 8, there are 8 pendant vertices attached to one of the vertices of K26. This is K26, the complete bipartite graph K26. At one of the vertices we have got 8 pendant vertices. This graph is also even graceful. So we have seen several families of even graceful graphs. Now we go to another, this is the topic of today's lecture actually, even graceful labeling. One Dr. M. Sudha has introduced the concept of even graceful labeling in the year 2013. You see the definition, a PQ graph is said to be even graceful if there is a bijection F from the edge set EG. So first we are labeling the edges here, that's the difference. The edge set EG to the set 2, 4, etc., 2Q, even numbers, such that the induced mapping F star on the vertices of G defined by F star V equal to sigma F UV mod 2K, the sum taken over all edges incident with V, where K is the maximum of P and Q, the maximum of the number of vertices and number of edges, and 2K is used here for the modulus. So first we label the edges, those labels induce a labeling of the vertices, that is happening here. Okay. Here is an example of an even graceful labeling of the path P5. So the first we have to label the edges. The labels are there are twice the number of edges. We'll see, go back. Twice the number of edges, 2, 4, etc. up to 2Q. 2, 4, etc. up to 2Q. So the labels here are 2, 4, 6, 8. 2Q is 8 because Q is 4. So they induce a label on the vertices. So the modulo has to be modulo 2K. Modulo 2K. 2K, K is the maximum of P and Q. Here the maximum of P and Q, there are 5 vertices, 4 edges, the maximum of P and Q will be 5. Again, at each vertex you have to sum the edge labels over the edges. For example, here there is only one edge, so the sum is 4. Here it is 8 plus 4 is 12, modulo 10 you have to take, so it is 12. Here at this vertex, 8 plus 2, 10, modulo 10 will be 0, it goes like that. So at each vertex, you take the sum of the labels of the edges, which you have already labeled. Such a graph is called an even graceful graph. Even graceful labeling of some tree related graphs are given below. The first theorem says, the path P2n plus 1, a path of having odd length 2n plus 1, is even graceful, where n is any positive integer. Another theorem, a star graph, the star graph K1n is even graceful, where n is any positive even integer. Here is a labeling of this star graph K116. In this graph, the labels of the edges, first we label the edges. Labels have to be 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, etc. up to 32. Here 2q is 32, q is the number of edges 16, number of vertices will be 17. So 2q will be twice 16, 32. So these are the available labels. They induce labels for the vertices. At each vertex, you add the label of the corresponding edges incident at that particular vertex. Take modulo 32, is that right? You take modulo 2k, twice the maximum of p and q. Here there are 78 vertices, the maximum is 17. So you take modulo 34. That gives you and induce the labels of the vertices. The graph K1n, the same integer has to be applied here. K1n, K1nw is even graceful, where n is any positive integer. Example given, even graceful labeling of K18, K18w. This graph we have already seen. Okay, a K18 here, another K18 here, connected to a vertex W. Here it is labeled 0. This graph is even graceful. Similarly, the graph PN4 is even graceful, where n is any positive integer. P1 repeated 4 times. Here P7 in the example repeated 4 times. So 4 paths having 7 vertices on the path. And they have the 4 paths have a common point, common vertex. And this graph can be, such graphs can be labeled even gracefulness is there. A perfect MRE tree having n levels is an even graceful graph, where m is an even positive integer and n is any positive integer. And below an example, even gracefulness of the perfect 4-array tree is given. This is a perfect 4-array tree. Each parent has 4 children. Each parent has 4 children. And it's perfect. There are 4 states actually. This is the 0 state level, 0 level, 1 level, 2nd level, 3rd level. Such graphs are even graceful. For any m, if m is any even positive integer and n is any positive integer. So here n equal to, in the example, n equal to m. Sorry, m equal to 4 and n is also 4 given here. The number of levels is meant by n. Then even graceful labeling of cycle related graphs. All cycles, any cycle of odd length is even graceful. The wheel graph Wn is even graceful when n congruent to 0 mod 4. So the wheel graph n W4, W8, W12, etc. are even graceful. Even gracefulness of the graph C9 is given, an odd graceful graph. The number of vertices given here is 9, C9. And the labels are 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, okay, twice 9. And the graph, the induced labels are 2, 6, 10, etc. Starting from 0, 0, 4, 8, 16, 18, 2 comes here, 4 comes here. 6 comes here, it is need not be in the same, on an order, okay. So that is even graceful. The even graceful labeling of the wheel graph is given where W8. There are 8 vertices, okay, around, and one vertex here at the center. So total 9 vertices, of course. And the center is labeled 8 here. Edges are labeled 2, 4, 6, etc. All the even numbers must come there, 2, 4, 6, etc. up to 16. So I don't think I need not explain that, okay, again and again. Then dumbbell graph, DNN is even graceful, where N is any positive integer. Even graceful labeling of D6 is given here. This is the dumbbell graph, two cycles, C6 and C6, two cycles connected by an edge. That is the dumbbell graph. These are to be proved. The theorems needs proof. A long proof is available. You can go through that. Let CNN be one vertex union of n copies of the cycle. One vertex union of n copies of the cycle CN for n greater than or equal to 3 and n is an odd number. Then G admits even graceful labeling. So this gives one parameter family of graphs. N is a parameter. You can see this. Okay, this beautiful graph C77 is even graceful. Similarly, the Cartesian product of P2 and a cycle CN. Cartesian product of P2 and CN is even graceful, where N is any positive integer. P2 cross C5 is given here. So P2 here, and two copies of C5 are one at the top, one at the bottom. So this graph is also even graceful. Now we shall see some relations between even graceful labeling and other types of labeling. Here is one, e-cordial labeling. What is e-cordial labeling? Let G be a graph with P vertices, Q edges. Let the edges be labeled with binary numbers 0 and 1. Define F star on the vertices by F star of V is sigma FUV mod 2. Sum taken over all edges incident with V, as in even graceful graph. The function F is called an e-cordial labeling of G if this difference is less than or equal to 1. Similarly, for edges, this difference is less than or equal to 1, where VF0 means the number of vertices labeled 0, and EF0 means number of edges labeled 0. This is the difference between the number of vertices labeled 0 and 1. This is the difference between the number of edges labeled 0 and 1. The difference should be less than or equal to 1, either 0 or 1. Such a graph is called an e-cordial graph. A graph is called e-cordial if it admits e-cordial labeling. And we are going to see that some even graceful graphs have e-cordial labeling. Let G be a perfect MRE tree. Perfect, important. If G has an even graceful labeling, then it is e-cordial. Here is a perfect 4-array tree. Each parent has 4 children, perfect 4-array tree. It is even graceful. The edges are labeled 2, 4, 6, 8, etc. up to 40. To move from here to the e-cordial labeling of that tree, it's the same perfect tree, you are going to have now a e-cordial labeling. What you have to do is divide each edge label here by 2 and take modulo 2. 2 by 2 is 1, modulo 2 will be, modulo 2 will be 1. 2 by 2 is 1, modulo 2 will be 1. 40. 40 divided by 2, it is 20. Modulo 2 will be 0. 4 divided by 2, 2. Modulo 2 will be 0. Similarly, 38 divided by 2, 19. Modulo 2 will be 1. Now you can see, concentrate on this graph, you can see that this is e-cordial labeling. If you count the number of edges with the zeros and count the number of vertices with the zero labelings, it will be equal here. So the difference is actually zero here. Now the labels for the vertices, that is by definition you have to compute them. This is the way to compute the labels for the vertices. You add the label of the edges incident with that vertex, you get the label for the vertex. For this vertex, the label is 1. Add and take modulo 2. For this vertex, the label will be 0 plus 1 plus 0 plus 1 plus 1. Okay, that is 3. Modulo 2 will be 1. So for this vertex, it will be 1. For this vertex, it will be 0. It goes on like that. If you verify, you will see that it is a e-cordial labeling that is obtained from this even-even graceful graph, which is an MRE tree. Here it is a 4-RE tree. Then relation between even-even graceful labeling and totally magic cordial labeling. A graph G is said to have totally magic cordial labeling with the constant C if there exists a mapping F from the vertices and edges to binary numbers 0, 1, such that Fu plus Fv plus Fuv is a constant modulo 2 for all edges in E, and this difference should be less than or equal to 1. Nf0 is the sum of the number of vertices and edges with label 0. So look at those labels on the vertices and edges, total them, that is nf0. Look at all those vertices and edges with label 1, total them, that is nf1. The difference between these two totals has to be either 0 or 1. If those who know a magic graph can compare this particular statement with a magic graph, the sum of the labels of any edge and its incident vertices, that has to be a constant. Here is a theorem. If a tree G is even-even graceful, then it is totally magic cordial. Totally magic cordial. Even-even graceful and totally magic cordial labeling of a 6-array tree are given. This is not a perfect 6-array tree, just a 6-array tree. Each parent has at most 6 children. Here is a parent who has got 6 children. Now, this graph is even-even graceful. It is already labeled with as an even-even graceful graph. The totally magic cordial labeling is obtained like this. It is a simple procedure. All the vertices you label by 1, all the edges you label by 0. Or the other way, you label all the vertices by 0 and all the edges by 1. What you get is a totally magic cordial labeling of this particular 6-array tree. If you add the labels of any edge with the end vertices, labels of the end vertices, you get 2. Modulo 2 will be 0. So the magic constant here is 2. Magic constant here is 0. I'm sorry, it is 0. It has to be C modulo 2. Then another relation. Relation between even-even graceful labeling and multiplicative labeling. A graph G with the vertices V and E and with P vertices is said to be multiplicative if the vertices of G can be labeled with distinct positive integers, such that the labels induced on the edges by the product of labels of end vertices are all distinct. So you can label with any distinct positive integers. You label the vertices with any positive integers. Okay. Then take the product of the end labels of the end vertices for each edge. Those labels have to be distinct. So first, okay, label the vertices. Here is an example. It's a quite complicated figure, but as a graph it is very simple. It is 6-array tree. Let G be an MRE tree, need not be perfect. If G is even graceful, then it admits multiplicative labeling. Here is the even graceful labeling of the 6th array tree. To move from here to here, to obtain a multiplicative labeling, you do like this. You multiply each label here by 2 and add 1. 50 into 2, 100, 100 plus 1, 101. 48 into 2, 96, 96 plus 1, 97. 0 into 2, 0, 0 plus 1 is 1. It goes like that. Now take the product of the end vertices for each edge. 1 into 141 will be 141. 1 into 145 will be 145. It goes on like that. Just take the product. Okay? You will see that this particular labeling is a multiplicative labeling. It is a multiplicative labeling. The definition says that you take the product of labels of end vertices in order to label the edges. Induce labels on the edges by the product of labels of end vertices are distinct. They have to be distinct. But you have to check whether these numbers are distinct. They will be distinct. Okay? That has been proved. The theorem has been proved. So you can be very confident that these numbers, very big numbers are there, they are all distinct. Relation between even graceful labeling and strongly multiplicative labeling. A graph G with P vertices is said to be strongly multiplicative if the vertices of G can be labeled with P distinct integers. So here integers cannot be anything. It should be 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. up to P, where P is the number of vertices, such that the labels induced on the edges by the product of labels of the end vertices are all distinct. Let G be an MRE tree. If G has an even graceful labeling, then it is strongly multiplicative. So all MRE trees, you get one family of graphs. They are all even grace. Okay. If it has an even graceful labeling, then it is strongly multiplicative. So an F is there. Now look at this. Even gracefulness of the 6th array tree is given here. It is labeled. Now to get a strongly multiplicative labeling of this 6th array tree, it's very simple. What you do is, you divide by 2 each vertex here and add 1, which we have already seen once. Divide the 8 by 2, add 1, you will get 5. Divide 2 by 2, that's 1, add 1, you will get 2. 0 divide by 2, add 1, you will get 1. But you have to check whether this is a strongly multiplicative labeling. The labels you have obtained for the vertices are, you can check 1, 2, 3, etc. up to P. P is the number of vertices. You count the number of vertices. You can see that it is 23. This 23 is the highest number here. 1 is here, 2 here, 3 here, 4 goes here, goes on like that. Okay? 5 here, 6, like that. So the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. up to P are used. Then you multiply the end vertices, the labels of the end vertices, you get the labels of the edges. There is no other condition here, just multiply and get the product. But the only condition is they have to be distinct in the definition. Then vertices, end vertices are all distinct. That is the only condition you have to check. That is the only point you have to prove in this theorem. They will be distinct. Then the relation between even graceful and modular multiplicative divisor labeling. What is modular multiplicative divisor labeling? Let G be a graph with P vertices is said to have a modular multiplicative divisor labeling if there exists a bijection F from vertices of G to 1, 2, 3, etc. up to P, and the induced function F on the edges, e.g. to 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. up to P minus 1, where F star is defined as usual, take the product, take modulo P, such that P divides the sum of all edge labels of G. Okay? You label the vertices with 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. up to P. Then find the induced labels on the edges. Because you take modulo P, the induced labels will be the remainders 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. up to P minus 1 only. So this is a theorem we have proved. Let G be an emery tree. If G has an even graceful labeling, then it admits modular multiplicative divisor labeling. An emery tree need not be perfect, just an emery tree. Here I have given a 6 array tree. The graceful labeling of this 6 array tree is here. To move from here to here, you look at the other vertices other than 0. 2 divide by 2, 2, 4, 6 divide by 2, 1, 2, 3. Okay. So it goes like that, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. up to 16. There are 17 vertices. The 17th vertex is chosen as this root node. So 17 is placed there. So all the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. up to P, 17 are used as labels of the vertices. Then you multiply the end vertices for each edge. You get the labels of the edges. 17 and 1 is 17. Modulo 17, P is 17 here. Modulo 17 is 0. So get everywhere 0 here. 14 and 11. Multiply, take modulo 17, you will get 1. You can check. Okay. 1 into 13, 13. Modulo 17 will be 13. Less than 17, so it's 13. Here it is 40. 4 into 10 is 40. Modulo 17 will be, you remove 34, you get 6. So you get a modular multiplicative divisor labeling of the 6 array tree, which is even graceful. Then we move to K even graceful graph. Just we shall see the definition. What is K even graceful graph? A PQ graph is said to be K even graceful, K greater than 0, if there is a bijection F from the edge set EG to the set 2K. You start from 2K. In even graceful, you start from 0. 0, 2, 4, etc. up to 2q minus 2 we had. You put in 2k extra. 2k, 2k plus 2, 2k plus etc., 2q minus 2. Such that the induced mapping F star on VG defined by once again adding the edge labels, edges incident with some taken over all edges incident with B. Where this Z, modulo 2 Z is maximum of P and Q. Makes all vertex labels distinct. So this construction is same as that for an even graceful graph. The definition is same except for this addition 2k. Instead of 0, you have 2k. Instead of 2, you have 2k plus 2. Instead of 4, you have 2k plus 4, etc. You get a k even graceful graph. I'll show you one beautiful k even graceful graph. 6 even graceful labeling of the friendship graph. This graph is called the friendship graph. They consist of, Fi consists of 5 cycles. 5 cycles, each of length 3. So friendship graph, it's required that it has to be 3. Cycles of length 3 having a common point. This is a 6 even graceful. So starting from 6, instead of 2k, you start from 6. I'm sorry, start from 12, 2k. So starting from 12, there must be 14 next, 16, 18 must be somewhere here, 18, 20, it goes like that. After that, to compute the vertex labels, you add the edges incident with those vertices and take modulo 2k. K is the 2z, where z is the maximum of P and Q. Okay, compute the maximum of P and Q, you will get modulo 40. You can total this, take modulo 40, you will get 0. Okay? So thank you for listening. You have taken your time. Thank you very much. Now we continue. The questions can be asked. One question I have received is, can you give the applications of this theory? And there's one application I will tell you that's actually given here. There is a K-even graceful labeling in multi-protocol label switching. This is a theory which is in computer science and engineering. They have used this K-even graceful labeling concept to this concept called multi-protocol label switching. In routing problems, this particular process is used. And if you want to learn more about this, one thing is you can go to the papers of one Dr. Sudha, or you can even search in the net. Then another question, give some suggestions to extend this theory. Now one extension which needs concentration is this one, K-even graceful graph. Today's lecture objective was to finish off this even graceful graph. So I have already given you an extension of this theory, even gracefulness, to K-even gracefulness. So that is included here. There may be many more extensions, depends on the scholar who studies this portion will have some intuition, use the intuition, okay, and find out the extensions of this theory. Any other questions?
Thank you so much, sir, for your informative talk about even graceful labeling of various graphs. Now, I invite Dr. Vijay Kumari Sarada, Assistant Professor of Mathematics, to propose a vote of thanks.
Good morning to all. I feel honor and privilege in getting this opportunity to propose the vote of thanks in the present occasion. First and foremost, I thank God Almighty for making this event possible. I would extend my sincere gratitude to the Honorable Chief Guest, Dr. H. Chandrababu, former HOD of Mathematics, the American College Autonomous, Madurai, for accepting our invitation in his busy schedule and delivering such an informative lecture on this topic, even gracefulness of some families and graphs. I wish to express my gratitude to our Principal Ma'am, Dr. C.M. Batma, for providing encouragement and support. I am very grateful to our correspondent, sir, Dr. J. Asir Parke Singh, for giving us an opportunity to organize this webinar. My sincere gratitude to Dr. S. N. Lina Nelson, the head of the Department of Mathematics, also the convener of this webinar, for her moral support and guidance. My special thanks to the technician, Mr. Michael Ogilvy, for his web screening support. I am very glad and thankful to all the participants for the valuable presence and support, which is highly appreciated. Once again, I thank you one and all. Stay home, stay safe.
Once again, I thank the management, the principal, Dr. C. M. Padma, the correspondent, Dr. J. Asir Pakesing, the resource person, Dr. A. Chandrababu, the technician, my dear colleagues, and all the participants. Thanks to one and all.